It's new star, information is power. The current, the news headline. In Abdikanu, I am not perturbed by Buhari's statement. In Abdikanu,
the leader of the proscribed indigenous people of Biafra, IPOB, said that he is not perturbed by the statement made by President Muhammadu Buhari. Buhari, in an interview with Chinese television TV, says that despite the appeal of the elders, he would not, you know, allow Mazen Abdikanu to be released, except if he is willing to change, which a political solution may thereof come in. But then, since he cannot release Mazen Abdikanu. However, Abdikanu spoke through his counsel. Ifeanyi Ejiofor on Thursday said he only demands a fair hearing and treatment. Speaking after a visit to Abdikanu at the DSS custody, Ejiofor said, "We were not one bit perturbed by Buhari's response, knowing fully well that they have no case against our client. What we are earnestly asking for is nothing else but the executive arm of government led by the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria to desist from further interfering in the judicial process. We can authoritatively confirm to the world that the executive arm of the world, of the government of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, ably led by the President, is gravely and effectively interfering in our client's judicial proceedings."
Treason accusations brought against him by the federal government, and this was the reason why President Muhammadu Buhari was asked during an exclusive interview with Channels TV. He had said that Mazen Abdikanu would actually not be released and should account for everything he had said while outside the country, and this was made known why Buhari said that it was a difficult decision for him just to, say that he would release Mazen Abdikanu when he has not realized that what he did was wrong, and that no political solution will be addressed, can be used, saying that he would actually, allow the legislative, the judiciary rather, to do their work, because one thing that, one office arm that he respects and does not want to interfere into is the judiciary.
Those people of Biafra leader, Mazen Abdikanu, while speaking, Abubakar Malami made it known that the president will continue to consider the interest of over 200 Nigerians before he can think of releasing Mazen Abdikanu. It could be recalled that the former aviation minister, Mbazulike Amichi, actually went with the elders of the Southeast to meet President Muhammadu Buhari, to seek the release of Abdikanu. However, it is think it was actually said, by the Attorney General of the Federation as at then, that a political solution can actually, foster the release of Mazen Abdikanu. But now, it is obvious that the Abubakar Malami has a vital point here, that the interest, of Nigerians, should be considered first before doing anything. And then, these IPOB members are truly, Nigerian citizens, and their interest as well should be considered, because if it can happen to Mazen Abdikanu, it can happen to anybody. And the interest of Nigerians, must truly be considered first. But nevertheless, one has to still chill and wait to see what will happen in this year 2022, as the indigenous people of Biafra had actually said that Mazen Abdikanu must be released this year.
Challenges. Kanu stated that the action of the defendants on a solitary confinement is inhumane, degrading, and constitutes a breach of Section 34 of the 1999 Constitution. He wants the court to declare that the respondents, while carrying out their duties, are to abide by Chapter 4 of the 1999 Constitution. Kanu is praying the court to declare that he is entitled to the enjoyment of his rights to dignity of human person as enshrined under Section 34 of the 1999 Constitution. He also wants the court to order the respondents to immediately allow him appoint legal practitioners and medical personnel of his choice from any government hospital to review his health file. Kanu equally wants the court to direct his movement from solitary confinement to where he would be allowed, to pray and practice his faith unhindered in line with constitutional provisions. And this was the agitation of Mazen Abdikanu, who is at the DSS facility, saying that after the court had said that he be allowed to be to be in the DSS facility with enough attention and comfortability, and he should be given everything needed there. And sees that in the suit filed by his lawyer, Maxwell Okwara, sees before the High Court that he's still denied of food and medical care, clothes of his choice, and tried to practice his religion. Also seeing that Mazen Adekanu claimed that the doctor that has been attending to him is a quack doctor and not experienced.
After I read the report in Tribune newspaper where the Imo State governor said this, I thought it would be nice to take a look at the present situation of the country to know if Hope Uzodema is right by that statement. Despite COVID-19 pandemic, Nigerian was able to come out of recession. Hope Uzodema believes that Buhari has done well by moving the country out of the recession, despite the COVID-19 pandemic that was ravaging the whole country. But some people will disagree with Uzodema because the cost of living is high, which is a clear sign that people cannot feel the impact of the recession which the country has exited. For example, the cost of cooking gas has tripled and the value of Naira is reducing by day. Also, many Nigerians are beginning to wonder how things will be if the federal government removes subsidy by the middle of next year. In addition, the insecurity in northern Nigeria has made it impossible, you know, for farmers to go to the farm, and the consequence is an increase in food commodities like onion, yam, and tomato. I want to believe that Hope Uzodema made a political statement because ordinary Nigerians who are battling hardship will disagree with him that Nigerians are happy with the president. People are joining the APC. What some people will ask is if joining the APC is a yardstick to measure the rate at which people are happy with the president. Uzodema forgot that ordinary Nigerians who struggle by day after survival and not political power. It is common sense to say that people who join the APC are this time looking ahead of the 2023 general election. While Uzodema is entitled to his opinion, I doubt if ordinary Nigerians who are complaining of the high cost of living will agree with him that people are happy with President Muhammadu Buhari, and that is why the APC is welcoming new members. This may be outrightly wrong, saying that the people are joining APC because they are happy with President Muhammadu Buhari, looking at the adverse effect of the COVID-19 pandemic and also the clear sign of impact of the recession which the country had just exited, where the cost of foods, gas, and many others are just so high that Nigerians are beginning to wonder if the federal government, you know, would actually increase yet again, remove yet again the subsidy and the adverse effect on the Nigerian populace.
Next Saturday to witness the presentation of a classic book written by Governor Hope Uzodema. The book, titled Reflections on the Igbo Question, is a bold attempt to situate the marginalization of Indibo in Project Nigeria and how best to overcome it.
Thanks for listening, and that is the news.